moving ahead, the third panel discussion for today, and the topic that we are going to discuss is third-party digital measurement. Is it the need of the hour? But before we invite the panelists, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming on stage our moderator, Megha Tata, COO, BTVI, to join us on stage and say a few words.
Ladies and gentlemen, sorry. I know we are right between lunch and the break. So, but before we start the panel, I wanted to take this opportunity very quickly to showcase with you a film which is for an event which is going to be one of the industry's biggest event being happening in India. It is the IAA World Congress, which is happening in February 20th to February 22nd in Kochi. And I would like to share a short film so you get a sense of the expanse of what we are looking forward. And we'll chat on that in a bit. But can we have the film, please?
Digital technology started maturing to the point where consumers were constantly connected, whether it be first by desktop, now of course by mobile. Then that changed the way they communicate with each other and the way they communicate with brands. And so that's changed our advertising model completely.
Yeah. And if you don't have a globally competitive digital tools and skills, you simply will not survive. You will get disrupted. You will be out-competed. You will be left behind.
A lot of retail brands today are struggling in a brick and mortar world, and we really want to benchmark our experience in the online world for our expertise in the digital space to support the growth in a brick and mortar world.
If you want to grow, you need to innovate around that. How do you attract new customers in a new and better way? Where the costs today are often Facebook or Google, you need to rethink the whole model you're doing. You need to use technology to actually enable that.
Entire industries will change and emerge as data speeds go up and data costs come down. We're used to getting cloud-based data and applications from anywhere, but get ready, because that experience is going to get a whole lot better.
Every 15 years, there's something incredibly transformative, right? It was PCs, then it was internet, and now it's mobile. We think actually the next one will likely be virtual reality.
I'm very excited about technological advancements that will more closely couple humans and machines. Who knows, maybe the research that goes into creating my body will be useful for similar applications.
More than ever, showing your leadership in the area of sustainability will place you very well. Because the future issues that we need to solve are obviously the challenges of climate and energy or water or biodiversity or natural capital and many of the other things.
I don't care how big the mountain is. We can take one step at a time and be proud of whatever it is we're setting about doing and have purpose in that. I need to know where the starting point is. What's the starting point?
Today, through technology, in 1 second, we communicate with the whole world. In the same way, if we can tune our minds to that simplicity, the innocence, to caring and sharing, we will find the whole world as one family.
just doesn't get bigger than this. We worked on a very simple brief, make it the biggest, make it the best. I'm told it takes three things to make for a fantastic experience, a memorable event, which is destination, content, and entertainment. Destination, Kochi, one of the best destinations we could have. Content, you've seen some 10-odd speakers who are here, but we have 34 confirmed speakers, and each one a gem who have come across the world for this conference. And of course, entertainment, we have three nights of fantastic entertainment lined up, including a Manish Malhotra fashion show. And of course, if you're doing an event of this scale in India, you can't do it without a Bollywood extravaganza. So be there. Please book yourselves if you haven't already registered. Please tell your friends and colleagues to register for this biggest event industry would have hosted, which is the IAA World Congress, February 20th to 22nd, Kochi. So that was my little plug I wanted to do.
Now is the time for us to introduce the panelists for this panel discussion. The topic that we're going to discuss is the third party digital measurement need of the hour. We have the moderator on stage. Now it's the time for us to introduce the panelists. Ladies and gentlemen, with a huge round of applause, let's welcome our first panelist, the co-founder and CEO, The Media Street, Ashutosh Joshi. The managing director, Performix and Resultrix, Mayuri Gango. CEO of EARC India, Mr. Partho Das Gupta. The head, brand and corporate communications, ICICI, Sujit Ganguly. And the CEO of Z5 India, Mr. Tarun Katyal. Thank you very much, and I leave the stage to you.
Thank you so much. Hopefully, we'll have an interesting, engaging conversation. Welcome, my fellow panelists. Really appreciate coming from your busy schedules and spending time on what I think is a very important topic of discussion, considering that the world is all going digital. There is so much of discussion, so much money being spent on these platforms, but one of the things which we all keep discussing in coffee breaks and over a drink maybe, that there is possibly a need for a third-party measurement system in our industry, which doesn't really exist at this moment. But before we get on to a set of questions which I have lined up for our fantastic panel, I thought I'll set up a context, and let me just take share some notes which I have shared. Digital media is part of we're part of that whole ecosystem today, and it's an integral part, not only as a consumer, we all are consuming content through different platforms and different devices, but even the entire ecosystem is an integral part, which is the advertisers or the marketers or the agencies or the platforms, of course. If you look at some of the statistics, and I'll take a second about to share some statistics. Now, according to the Indian Media and Entertainment Reports by FICCI and EY, India has 480 million internet users, and it's likely to go up to 830-odd million by 2021. Out of these 480 million, 250 million, nearly half of it, is viewing video online. The average time spent on these devices has grown to 52 minutes in 2018, and it was only 2 minutes just about 5 or 6 years ago. So there's been a huge jump of consumption through these platforms. And we're supposed to grow to 650 million smartphones by year 2019. And market is exploding, more smartphones are coming out there, data is getting reduced. So clearly there is a market out there where the large universe which is being created to be consumed and to be monetized. And we also know that, and Atit mentioned that the advertisers go where eyeballs go. So, the larger the universe out there consuming, that's where the advertiser wants to go. And I think my estimate says about 12,000 to 13,000 crores of revenue is being spent on advertising on these digital platforms. However, nearly 60 to 70% of that money is going to only Google and Facebook. And that is the big question. Not a question, but that's a point we need to ponder upon as to, how do other media platforms and digital platforms probably get a certain percentage of that pie. And while there are many players like GSK and other FMCG, Nestle are spending a lot of money on digital, we also have clients like P&G and Unilever who are actually reducing their spends on digital. And for many reasons, whether there has been questions on ROI or maybe some of the audit frauds which have come out there. So one doesn't know what could be reasons for their reduction of spends on digital at the moment. And I think one of the things which we all sort of banter about is that, then why, if there is so much of ambiguity still, then why are the digital agencies pushing so much money onto the digital platforms? Is it because they get a higher cut on digital spends versus the traditional spends? I don't know, worth to ponder upon. And in all this, of course, one of the things which completely gets questioned is the fact that where is the measurement happening? Today, if Google provides you their analytics, Facebook is providing their analytics, but that is the platform itself providing. How much, what are the questions we should be asking? Why cannot there be a third-party measurement like there has been in for every other medium which has been in the business, whether it's TV, print, radio? But digital is one medium where we don't have that. So to set that context, and I'm a believer of a phrase which says, "Baat karne se baat banti hai." So chalo baat karte hain, and that's the reason I will bring in the conversation back into the panel. So I'll dig in first straight to Sujit, actually to you. You're a big supporter of the digital platform, and you believe. Yeah. you believe, if I'm not wrong, about that spending money on content on this platform has given you dividends. But what if you spend a lot of money on creating some content on this digital platform, and you hypothetically spend that on, say, a Facebook, and then Facebook suddenly one day decides that to change the algorithm and deprioritize that to really, sort of promote it within the ecosystem. How then do you justify spending that kind of money on a platform, on such platform, where the distribution control is with the platform itself?
So I'll answer it in two parts of what we are satisfied with and what the second part will be what extra we would want. As a BFSI player, what we are currently happy about digital is that we can get, unlike some other industries, we can directly track the leads, we can directly track applications for our products, for our loans, which we can come in from its site. We can also sell a few products that are allowed online. We can also get for our different products the exact traffic coming to our website from different media platforms. So that's something that's a good part of it, which is where I guess digital already good work has happened in comparison to perhaps other media. What is the next step that we should move towards measurement, and which is where third party comes in? Simple things like if there are six people here and I want to reach out to all of us through a video, I will not be able to understand in a unique manner who are the number of unique people who I'm able to reach out across platforms. For each platform, I will get its own figure, but I don't know the duplication across platforms. And the second point is, as you rightly said, I'm getting that reach figure from that platform. It's not independently verified, point number one. Point number two, the parameters are different. A video view is not a video view as measured in the same manner across platforms. Maybe a lot of advertisers that I talk to don't realize that on some platforms, a video view is actually close to an impression, 2 seconds. Wo video hua ki nahi hua, I don't know, right? And so there are some people, some agencies, some tech players who come and say, I can bridge this. I don't know if it's verified or not. In one case, we started working with them, and as we started working, we realized that the results are not as great as it was promised. So in a sense, what I'm trying to say is that there are some good aspects of digital because we're able to measure a lot of things, especially as a bank, because we get applications and business. But there are a lot of other places where I think there is an urgent need for a third-party measurement, an urgent need for common metrics, an urgent need for being able to identify audiences seamlessly across platforms. I think that's an important
point. And that's a great point there, Sujit, because I think that's really what the crux of this conversation is, whether And how do we really go about it? And we'll come to Partho in a minute on that. But before that, Mayuri, I read somewhere you had mentioned that there is order in chaos here and there is an honesty to digital marketing that makes it something I really enjoy. How do you comment then the skepticism which exists out there on the same honesty which you were referring to? And how are you dealing with this multiple change of digital technology, which is every day there's a new technology coming in, and today's technology is already obsolete tomorrow. So how do you work in that environment?
With a lot of difficulty. But that being said, you know, I've only worked in digital, right? It's only in the last 6 years that I've been exposed to media outside of digital. And I think one of the biggest disadvantages, especially when I see the Indian landscape that the digital media has, in comparison to others, that it's always been accountable and always been measurable to the last mile from its inception in India. Let me clarify what I say. When digital grew in India, it grew on the back of search, okay? And majority of that goes to your website, from which, like Sujit mentioned, is an action that you take. Right, and that action is actually a fulfillment of whatever the brand's KPI was. And those are the brands that grew in digital in India. It is only in the last 5 years that you've seen a lot of FMCG, and I'm specifically speaking about India, and Facebooks and all of that that have come up, and even YouTube for that matter, that the complexity has increased. When I say that what I love about digital is, the fact that whether you're on Facebook, whether you're on YouTube, whether you're on DPM, whether you're on Google, you know beyond somebody just watching, okay? Because that's the last metric when you talk about television, or whether you're talking about a print readership, or you're talking about outdoor, which is really not measurable to that manner. So if you compare digital to your other mediums, it's still a lot more measurable beyond just, did somebody watch it? Now, but that does not take away from the fact that over the last 5 years, it's gotten a lot more complex, because we are not just dealing with search, we are not just dealing with YouTube, we are dealing with multiple platforms, and each platform in its own way is a walled garden. And yes, so the need of the hour is to A, understand what is that metric that really matters. Is it impression or is it attention? Because is a TV being on really somebody watching your ad? Is a video being scrolled somebody not really watching your ad? So what is it that, what do we mean by that metric? And at the end of the day, so when you work in this complex ecosystem, you have to rely on the tools that are available. And the reason you see so many tools and so many things, which is a new kid on the block coming and going every day, is because nobody has the answer. It's a very nascent ecosystem. And in these ecosystems, that is the duopoly. And it's really difficult to work around that duopoly to come up with an integrated way of measurement today. Also, it's not a singular format of creative. So it's a very complex ecosystem to measure.
No, you're right. I mean, I think if there is actual conversions happening, like Sujit mentions, you know, then there is a bit of a specific quantifiable data which can do. I think the question or the ambiguity exists in advertising spends which are happening on brands, where there is not a direct conversions taking place. So how do you sort of look at, the ROI of those spends? So taking that to Tarun now. Tarun, you're running a big platform now, and you come with such rich media experience. Do you think the platforms which are the data they are providing should be trusted, and if so, why?
Interesting. I think there have been some skepticism about the data that has come through, and we've seen some reports about bots and Facebook and so on and so forth, and I don't think there's going away from those realities. But I also must say that the amount of tools that today digital provides for final level attribution, like Mayuri was saying, is far better than, she spends a lot of her money every month. It's far better than...
It's well spent, Mayuri.
So it is a journey that everybody is taking, right? But the final level attribution that you get on digital is far better than what you can get anywhere else. I can tell you, we spend a significant amount of investment every month, because we are an upcoming platform, and we also own a significant amount of traditional media ourselves. But when it comes to performance marketing, right, I think what digital can give you today, no other media can give you. And you're right. I think the questions are around branding and around some amount of you know, video marketing and so on and so forth. But let me tell you about video, right? We work with video and we are a large video platform, and we've also now going to add performance tools onto our platform. But if you look at either Moat or DAR or some of the other attribution tools, they still give you much better final level attribution than what, you know, some of the traditional media will. Like, you look at print. 40% of India's ad is on print. What's the frequency of IRS?
Yeah, true.
What is it?
Well,
whatever it is, you know, it's better. It comes once. They said they'll get it once in every 6 months or whatever, twice a year, so on and so forth. But Anita is smiling over there. I mean, if it comes out properly once a year, it's a big deal. And if publishers don't, you know, go to court against it and so on and so forth, right? It happens. It's a jamboree. Yeah. I am talking about last mile video attribution, and you're talking about a once a year or once in 2 years study that is done with, you know, with huge amount of discrepancies in it. And 40% of India's addicts lies there. The difference is not even comparable.
But then again, taking that point further, in terms of getting this, so you need data on a, you need measurement on almost a daily basis of how this consumption.
Digital will gives you, so let me also tell you, right? You may not have data from every, or you get data from every platform, but attribution tools are all yours, right? So somebody like Sudhit, if he's looking for downloads or leads, you can always have a third-party tool like Moat, DAR, AppsFlyer, many others, which will give you attribution to the advertising that you make on a platform, but the delivery that happens on your own platform for that. Every advertiser is able to use different tools, and there are many like this, third-party tools, to measure the success of your campaign on an ongoing real-time basis. Today, if I want app downloads, right, and if that's my KPI, I have enough tools to see what my advertising will deliver on any XYZ platform through a third-party tool. I may not be able to build classic reach frequency plans across platforms, and that's a point Sujit made, that, you know, what's the duplicated reach between platforms and so on and so forth. Yes, that is a challenge that still exists, but we also must remember that this is all user-level data, right? And while we all want to build a third-party tool that can build reach across platforms, it's tricky on how much user-level data can you share with a third-party agency for you to be able to build a tool like this, right? And that's why over the years we haven't made progress to it, because if somebody like Bach comes in, which they should, but if their ask is to put an SDK on my app and many other, you know, millions of publishers in this country, because it's not like TV, right, which is a limited number of TV channels whose signals can be encoded. But if they were to get onto an SDK or an API integration with, you know, millions of publications and pull data, what kind of data should you allow to pull? What kind of user data is allowed to be pulled? And a lot of the good countries across the world where GDPR is getting now, becoming the law, a lot of this data is not allowed to be shared, right? The cookie game is getting over. And if I don't opt in, then you can't even share my data with anybody else, let alone with a third-party tool. So you'll never know, right? Because if I'm, and most people don't opt in. And if I'm not an opted-in person, then how will you sell my data to anybody else or to know whether I'm on the platform or not? I can, at the max, serve advertising to you on my platform, but I can definitely not share my data about you to somebody else for them to be building reach over multiple platforms. So it's not that the platforms don't want to do it. It is a slightly larger challenge that we all need to deal with.
No, clearly, I mean, obviously, there's no denying the fact that the challenge exists. And I think what I'm also hearing is that there is a need, however, which is required for a third party. So moving into then Partho, you know, the man in the middle of all this, literally. what, according to you, are the key challenges you think are there to bring in a third party measurement in this crazy digital world?
See, I'll take it in three parts, split it in three parts. One is, how do you, I think there's no point even talking about why is it important and all that. And I think every other forum that I go to, I think this is a typical discussion which I'm hearing for the last 2 years, but still nothing has happened, right? I mean, the whole challenge lies in, as Tarun had said, Mayuri has also said, about duplicated reach, unique reach, or whatever, you know. And the fact is, Coffee with Karan, do you really watch it on your laptop or your mobile or actually on a cable TV, so to speak, classical cable TV, is what one needs to distinguish, because ultimately it's all about content. The issue lies first in collecting the data, okay? And when you really sit down in doing it, like Tarun rightly said, there are too many walled gardens, yeah? And people will all agree in forums like this that data needs to be collected, but when you really go to them with a tool, like say for example, and I've said this before somewhere else also in Singapore, that when you go with a tool to actually do your ECG, they will say, okay, you want me to be measured, my health to be measured, put the probe from here, somebody will say put it from there, and somebody will say put it from there. It doesn't work, right? If you want your health measured, you have to measure it in a certain way. Second part is the reporting the data. Again, like I think people have alluded to here also, whether it's a 2 second, whether it's a 15 second, whether it's a 6 second. A lot of ads are being made in 6 seconds in US these days, right? The parity in reporting is also very important. And then comes the other layer, which is your ad fraud, your brand safety, and all of that, right? So there are these three buckets I would put the challenges in. It's not that it cannot be done, but it requires the will of everybody working here, starting from a man who spends the money, to publishers who wants the money to be well spent, and agencies who are facilitating that. It requires the will of everybody together to do it.
So before I actually come back further to you, Partho, I want to rope in Ashutosh now. Your company, The Media Street, is primarily US-based, right? What have you faced as challenges? You think these are the issues you're dealing out there as well, and what are the ways you have overcome them?
Right. So one of the biggest issues right now that most marketers globally, and it's not just US or India, is there are two challenges, actually. One is fraud and bot, and the other is viewability on the actual user, right? So bot at this point is eating away about 21% of all ad spend that is happening. For example, P&G has cut down its spends drastically. You know, it has cut down to about like 15% from what it used to spend. We need third party. Like you have Moat, you have IAS, you have a lot of other partners over there who go ahead and, you know, measure fraud, measure bot and all. But if you look at each reporting structure that is there, there is no measurement over there. No one is going to go ahead and say what is your ROS, what is your return on ad spend that is happening. You know, everyone calculates it differently. A brand like P&G uses 5 different vendors. A brand like GSK uses 3 different vendors. The amount of money they spend on third-party measurement tools is greater than the amount they spend on media buying itself, right? These are expensive tools. But the point is it's needed. The kind of bot we see, the kind of fraud we see, it's the amount of sophistication of bot that is happening is crazy, right? If you look at the other part, the viewability part, right? And we kind of specialize in that. You have Moat, which kind of you know, goes to the level of viewability that you know, advertisers want. But even after that, do you actually get the return on the ad spend? So we need a uniform, the MIRC, the IAB, the IAB India, the IAB Singapore, the IAB US. Everyone has to have a say in what actually measures. You know, what is the actual viewability that is there? Whether there's a return on investment for the advertiser. You go ahead and you play a video. The video is 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 6 seconds, 30 seconds. Doesn't matter. But is there a return on investment? Right? I spend $15 CPM on buying a video of you. But whether the view is being measured by the actual user, one, whether the user who's actually viewing it is in the viewable area at that point of time, and whether I get a return on investment, whether there's engagement on the ad. There are a lot of metrics. See,
as so Mayuri, you provide those metrics? Do you have that tools out there?
Absolutely. So we kind of measure viewability right from the ad request to ad response to ad rendered. And at the end of the day, we go back to the advertiser and say that this was your bid. You were bidding at $5 CPMs, but you know, your actual inventory worth is just $1.5 or $2. at the end of what we need to understand is that the advertiser is, you know, they spend millions of dollars yearly. The whole industry is worth $236 billion at this point of time. Are they getting the return that they require? And it's not the publisher's fault. I'm not saying it's the publisher's fault. I'm not saying whether it's Facebook's fault or anyone else's fault or a Yahoo's fault that the bot is creeping in. It is just that there are players in the market who benefit from it. And it's our responsibility to ensure that the advertisers, someone like ICICI or a Nestle or a P&G, get back that money's worth. That's where I'm at.
So, I mean, there's obviously so much, ambiguity again in this space. So, Mayuri, do you think clients should be asking for audited reports from platforms? How do you think what's the short-term possible solution till possibly a third-party measurement comes into this space?
So there is third-party measurement, like he mentioned. So, advertisers who spend a humongous amount of money in branding, I think it's much more a need for them than advertisers who are spending it on performance, because performance, most of the campaigns are last mile tracked, right? So there the issue is a little lesser than the issue on the brand side of digital. And a Nestle or a GSK, like you mentioned, have multiple tools that they use to measure both viewability and brand safety. Now, the point is how many platforms in India currently are opted into those tools? And this has only happened since that whole P&G thing happened about a year and a half ago, is where the awareness has come to these advertisers, specifically in the local markets, and hence they have started implementing them. So yes, definitely our advice to advertisers who are spending that kind of money on various platforms would be to definitely use a third-party verification tool. And we are also supposed to be there, and work on their behalf to make sure that when there is a fraud or when there is a drop beyond a certain threshold, to negotiate with publishers, to talk to them about how we can fix it, because we don't want money being spent for no rhyme or reason for anyone. Yeah. And I'm sure publishers want to fix it too. It's just the integration of technology takes time. And so while now a Facebook and a Google are in their ecosystems are probably geared to take that, the local publishers are working towards getting that. So I know that Z5 is now, you can use modes similarly with Hotstar or similarly with the larger publishers, you will start them seeing opt into it.
No, so clearly even Tarun mentioned that, there are multiple third-party tools, but there are multiple third-party tools, right? So there are different ones you're using. There's no one common metrics which can be used, which I guess overall the industry
wants. Do you really
want
that? Do you want a single tool? Because here we are talking about you don't want Google or a Facebook to dominate the ecosystem. Then do you really want one third-party tool? Wouldn't you rather have three or four who are robust enough?
Yeah. I think also the KPIs are very complex. They're very different. You can't have one tool for all kind of KPIs. There are branding KPIs, there are display KPIs, there are video KPIs. There are annotations and customer journeys from there. There are downloads. There are lead generations. It's too many things. People want different things from digital. People have never even asked these questions of 80% of the ad eggs that is spent between print and TV. I wonder what happened all these years. Right? And advertisers want such deep amount of data as well as attribution today. That, and I've come from traditional media. I'm really surprised. I'm like, you spend 500 crores on television. When have you last time, or print, when is the last time you asked those questions off there? But when you spend 5 lakhs on a digital medium, you want such granular attribution, it's not funny. Yeah.
Sorry.
So one is third party. Second, I feel is that within third party, the debate should also be on, should there be industry standards or not?
Right.
So I'll tell you, so there are two places where we are actually facing life problems. There are various platforms who come and talk about data-driven attribution models. Every platform wants to say, my contribution to your performance is far more than what last click says. So take my attribution model. I face two challenges there. First is it's a black box. I spend 4 hours on it, try to understand it. I take my BU analytics team also try and understand it. After some point, they say, look, we can't answer. It's been made in California. Right? We can't answer beyond this. But that's not the bigger problem. The bigger problem is if we add up the attribution tools of different platforms, you will actually get a performance which is more than 100% of what you've got. Because every platform is saying that as per last click, I'm X, but as per data-driven, I'm 3X. So if I add up the 3X, 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 I go beyond 100%. So because there is no industry standard, I don't know how to be able to. Point number one. Point number two, we have one of the largest apps, the largest app in the banking space, and in terms of transactions also it's big. So we drive a lot of download campaigns. We're working with perhaps the largest independent agency to monitor downloads. Last 6 months, I have not been able to get things right because the reporting, the payment happens on a, the reporting tool gets paid on a paper download basis, right? That's what, I don't want to take names, but I'm sure people are aware. The discrepancy is more than 100%. And it's not, I've not been able to resolve it. You do things like you stop the campaign, then you see what is happening. You start the campaign, then you see what's happening. And you're able to clearly understand that there are discrepancies. So issue is third party, but more than that, maybe is there a need for industry standards
which follow
minimum quality?
Absolutely.
So that you can,
advisors
can go and trust it.
Yeah. So, I mean, that is a very good point, Sujith. You know, it's not just the third party, it's the industry standard. And so just because the time's up, last question to Partho to wrap it up. When is ECAM happening, if at all?
ECAM. It's a Sanskrit word, so.
Okay, ECAM. ECAM.
Again. We have, I mean, just to give you a status, I mean, we are reasonably ready. POCs are done. Things are working well. We have things on the ground. The willingness or the will of everybody sitting here has to be shown.
Tarun, you'll support ECAM?
No, we'll support. I know Puneet's been a great supporter of ECAM himself. And we'll support any third-party tool. To be honest, is we just have to understand how much data we can pull, can be allowed to pull. What is the consumer, how the consumer is being treated, because it's not just us, it's not just the advertiser. You must remember, all this data is all of us here. And do you want your data to be passing on at various levels to various people? And we tend to have to remember that we are also all consumers. You know, and I know people who don't want their data to be going anywhere, move to feature phones. Right? And there are all sorts of people, to be honest, right? But there is a huge amount of concern around data protection and data privacy. So we've got to answer and tick a lot of those boxes before we take, you know, steps, because this is a good advertising forum. But if you were to be sitting on a consumer forum, the conversation would be very, very different here.
And the Sri Krishna Commission, the report, it is actually tougher than a GDPR that we discussed. We have gone through it in detail. It's slightly tougher.
And it talks of criminal liability.
Yes.
Yeah.
And you know, people like us could be in jail.
Yeah, we could be in jail if...
All right.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
So clearly, ladies and gentlemen, this is something which is, you can't have a decision and a sort of a culmination to this point, but it is what I'm hearing, and I think that's what we've heard, is that there is a need for an industry standard to be set. While there are multiple tools out there available, and the need for a third-party measurement stroke an industry standard is absolutely a need. How and when that takes place depends on a multiple set of challenges people like Partho have to deal with, and let's hope as an industry we are able to find a solution which will make everybody in the ecosystem happy. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for a wonderful panel. Thank you.